Username, Taylor Nelson. Password, Team Jacob. Login. Every day, I come home from school and the first thing I do is open up my laptop. My fingers automatically race across the keys. Facebook. Wait. What just happened? I don't think about it. I can't think about it. It's just become so second nature. Facebook.com. It's all typed in. All I have to do is press enter. So what's stopping me? This is my community. These are my friends. They're all here at the touch of my fingertips, the click of a button. I have 529 friends. Online, I feel popular, engaged. But in the real world, sometimes I feel alone. I make superficial connections. I leave nice and cute comments on their defaults, yet I can't bring myself to make eye contact with them in the halls. I like more than I love. I poke instead of hug. Social networking. How did a social networking become a substitute for real relationships? For friends? For family? My family doesn't live in the virtual world. They're still cooking dinner at soccer practice, reading books, going shopping. They're still living, breathing, moving. But I'm digital. I'm a profile picture, a status update, and about me. I want to remember what it feels like to be connected. Connected, connection, login, plug-in, wait. That's not the connection I want. To be truly connected, connected to people, places, life around me, God even, I need to unplug. God, oh yeah, I always seem to forget about him. He doesn't have a Facebook. Well, not really. He's not one of the 529, but does that mean our friendship isn't important? No, it's important. I mean, it's eternal. I can't block him, hide him, or ignore him. At the end of the day, he's still there. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. This is big. This is huge. This is the center of my faith, and it should answer all of my questions. And when I put my hands together in prayer, I too am connected. Relationships are a direct connection with God. Every person, each one of us, are linked to the Holy Trinity. We become part of a mystery that cannot be solved. This mysterious relationship between three people who share one nature. When I put my hands together in prayer, I am connected. No matter how hard I try, Google can't give me the answer. And maybe it's not supposed to. Even so, I believe it. But do I live it? If I honor an online relationship over a living one, then what do I believe in? Can I put my digital identity over a relationship that's more than an accepted friend request? A relationship that connects me to God? And if I do, then what do I believe in? Where is my humanity? Where am I going? How do I unplug? Does it even matter if I'm here or not? I'm thinking it doesn't. Thank you.